You all know what zero is in numbers, but did you know that some objects also behave like zero? An empty list, it is a zero in the set of all lists, for example. If you can recognize an object that behaves like a zero and model it explicitly, then your domain model will become easier to use and more intuitive. It is the null object pattern I'm talking about. One of the simplest design patterns in existence, but with a profound effect on domain modeling. Let me show you how that works in a realistic domain model. This is the application that models a bookstore. It lists some books. You can enter any of the books and see the details. That works fine, but there is one feature that is not implemented yet. Here, I want to see the invoices issued so far. Well, it throws the not implemented exception. Part of the application is still missing and it is waiting for us to implement it. This is the place. The invoice model, its total property getter is not implemented. It needs to sum up the money instances from the lines of the invoice. Unfortunately, it is not possible to sum up the money, which is a basic feature in this application. And you will see why we cannot do that if we try to implement this total property getter. There is the sequence of invoice lines, and each line is carrying its own cost. What we would normally do is to aggregate all the costs. Now, we don't know how many costs there are. Maybe the sequence is empty, so we need a zero. We need something to start with. Then we add individual prices to the sum. And this doesn't work because we are lacking the zero money amount. It is not easy. You cannot just create the money amount with the zero amount inside of it. Here is the culprit. We cannot instantiate a zero amount of money because we don't know the currency before the first instance of money comes from that sequence we are summing up. So we need a better definition of a zero money amount, a proper definition of a zero. And that is where null object pattern comes to the table. There are obviously two kinds of money, zero and non-zero. Because you can always add zero money to whatever else. You don't need to check the currency, because if it's zero, then there is no currency, there's nothing there. So here is the abstract money. And it will expose an abstract add operation. Let the money implement this interface, and I will use a coding trick to implement this method. Look, if the other money is this class here, then use the method below which acts on monies that have currencies. Otherwise, delegate to other, hoping that that class might know it better. Now, this implementation is perfectly correct, because at this moment, this money class, concrete class, is the only class that implements the iMoney interface. So it is correct, it will never execute the else branch. But the time has come to implement the alternative, the other money class, what that mysterious other money is. Let's add a touch of humor, that is when we have no money, so no money. Do you know what is no money added to anything? It is that anything. Zero doesn't change the other object. Let's get back to that add implementation in the money class. What will happen when its argument is no money instance? Well, we would call add on that instance. But if you look above, that instance will just return this. So in effect, add called on the money instance with no money argument will just return this. It is a kind of a double dispatch, if you like it that way. Both add implementations are perfectly correct even after adding the new class to the system. So this is the crux of it. You will see in a minute, using these classes will be very easy and very effective. In the rest of the demo, I will complete the implementation of the null object pattern, because this is not all of it. And I will also make some improvements to make it easier to use. Before that, let me remind you that if you liked this video so far and want others to discover it as well, the easiest way to help me is to press the like button right now. Thank you very much. And if you wonder where the source code for this video is, the source code is available to patrons, to sponsors of this channel. Please visit me at Patreon, become sponsor, help maintain this channel free for everyone, and gain access to source code and other goodies that are available there. The link to Patreon page is in the description. Let's continue. Completing the null object pattern starts from realizing that all zeros are the same. And so it is common to combine null object pattern with singleton pattern by first hiding the constructor and then exposing a statically instantiated object, so there will only be one instance of no money ever during the execution of this application. You can even use the latest feature from C# and expose a public static zero property getter on the interface. That will allow you to even remove the no money class from view, making it internal so that nobody can see it outside the domain model itself. But there is more. You can make extensions on the iMoney interface, like an extension method that sums the sequence of monies. That will be that same aggregate call that didn't work over there, but this time it's going to be very easy, because we have a zero. Seed it with iMoney.0, and then just use the add method to accumulate values on the sum. So easy. Maybe another one that accepts a selector to extract money from objects of type T. This is just a convenience. Use a select operator to dig the money out and then sum it up. We can fix this code that didn't work. Make the property return iMoney and use the sum extension method. Alright, I can run the application. I'm pretty sure it will work fine. This is the page with invoices. You can see that some invoices are not paid, some are overdue, too late with payments, and everything. The amounts, these total amounts, that is the sum of invoice lines in every line in every row of this table. And down below there is a special report of overdue customers. These total amounts are the sums of invoices issued to a customer, so that's another sum of monies, and that works fine as well. This is the implementation of the null object pattern. But now, I want to tell you a secret. Sometimes you don't have to implement the null object pattern if you're ready to add a bit of complexity into your class that would support zero. Because null object is adding complexity to your domain. Money has just become abstract in this model. Well, it's a bit complicated to impose an abstract type on the entire model. This is the application that obviously works with money. Every item in the store has a price. Every price becomes part of some invoice. Invoices are summing up the invoice lines. Reports are summing up the invoices. Everything is about money in this application. Well, will everything be abstract? That is creating a pressure, you know. Imagine having an abstract string. What would your code look like if the string were abstract? You can still retain a concrete class and let it do two things. I'm letting the money be the only implementation of money in this application again. There will be a special case, of course, that zero which must ignore currency. What I'm doing here is not a null object pattern. It is avoiding the use of null object pattern for the benefit of working with a concrete class, which is omnipresent in the entire domain model. All the models depend on it, and we want to avoid rising that simple concept to a level of an abstraction. But there will also be a private property to test if this instance is zero, because zero will have zero amount and no currency, and I want to know if this is a zero instance. It is private. I will be branching around this property getter in all the operations, like adding. Adding depends on whether the other is zero. Both ways, this instance could also be zero. And subtracting will become a true mess after adding the definition of the zero into this class. Look at this. If other is a zero, then this amount remains intact. Otherwise, if the other is not a zero, it means it's a positive amount. And this one is zero, then we cannot subtract the other one from this. We must throw. This operation is impossible. Beyond this point, both instances, this and the other, are non-zero. If the currencies do not match, we must fail. Then also fail if the other amount is greater than this one. Okay? Otherwise, if amounts are equal, the new result is zero. Otherwise, reduce the amount and retain the currency. Now, what you see here is the poor man's polymorphism. We had all this for free when we had two classes and an abstract money. It was the compiler's duty to choose which method to call. Now we must branch multiple times sometimes to just figure out what needs to be done. That is not object-oriented code. But again, there is a strong motivation to do it this way, retaining a simple interface, public interface of this class. So let me continue. We must complete this all the way through. Even to string will have to adapt and to branch. As I said, that is poor man's polymorphism. But on the plus side, all treatment of money is done in only one class, in only one place. And since this type is so present in all other models, we will benefit from this complication here. If nothing else, there's just one money type, not three types, as we had them with the null object pattern. I have fixed the extensions, everything compiles, I will run the application, show you the invoices page, and you will see that it is working fine. Implementation is more complex on the inside, but simpler on the outside, and everything works just fine. Again, you can download the full source code if you become a sponsor at Patreon. Use the link from the description. Thank you for watching this demonstration and see you in the next episode.